Hello automation animal lovers, welcome back to KT Sessions. And in today's session we are gonna see how can we read millions of rows from an Excel file. So guys, we are gonna use this Excel file in today's session. It contains thousands of records or rows. So guys, in one of the previous video we saw how can we use OLEDB in automation anywhere A360. So if you have not watched that video, so I will suggest you please watch that video first, then you will be able to understand this video or this session. So I have created this task bot. In this task bot, we are going to read 1 million rows from the Excel file. So guys, you may know sometimes if we read a lot of data from Excel and it gives some errors, means system out of memory or something, because it doesn't, sometimes our system's configuration has very low RAM or we have very slow processor, so we are unable to read the rows in one step or in one attempt. So we can't use Excel advanced packages or that Excel basic packages because we can't get all the rows in one attempt. So we are going to use OLEDB, and in this session or in this task board, we are going to read 3000 plus rows. So what we will do is we will read rows in small batches. Means first we will read 1000 rows, then we will read next 1000, like that. So for that, I have created this task board. So first of all, we are going to check the count of the rows. For that, we are using this query, select count star from sheet 1. So it will give the count of the rows. And after that, we will use a loop stage. As you may know, we use this loop stage to iterate over this database session, and then we will get the values. So if we execute this query, select count star from sheet 1, it will give the count of the total rows or records. So once we get the records count, let me show you. Yeah, so let me run the bot. We have 3841 rows, and first row contain headers, so there will be 3840 records. So here we go, we can see 3840 on our screen. So guys, we know the count of the records in our Excel sheet. So for example, we are assuming our system can read 4000 rows in one attempt easily. Means if we read more than 4000, then it may throw any exception or any error, but if we read 4000, then it can read it easily. So now we know the count, okay? So what we can do is, if we can apply a if condition, if the count is greater than 4000, in our case, we are assuming 4000. So if the count is greater than 4000, then we will divide the items into batches, means divide the records into batches, and then we will read. Otherwise, if the record count is less than 4000, means it will go to the else condition. So here we can read all the records in one attempt or in one step. Okay, so here we are reading all the records in one attempt, and then we will traverse over all those records, and then we can perform our steps, means we can process those records. Either we can input those records into the data table or database, then we can process those further. So whatever processing or business rules we want to apply on these records, so we can do that. But now, in case if our limit is 1000, means we can process only 1000 records, but our sheet contains 3840 records, which is greater than 1000. So in that case, what we will do is we will use a loop stage, means we will apply a while loop. And if the counter, we have taken a variable counter and we have assigned the value to 1. So what we will do is we will read first, means we have 3840 records. So first we will read from record number 1 to record number 1000. So we will read first 1000 records in first attempt, and then we will read next 1000 records in next attempt, and so on. So for that, I have applied a while condition. Let me show you. So we have taken a variable which is counter, and the initial value is 1, because in first attempt we are going to read from first record to 1000th record. Okay, and we are using a while loop, means if this counter value is less than the count of the record, till then it will use that loop stage. And in each iteration of the loop, we will increase the counter by 1000, means counter is equal to counter plus 1. So in first iteration, counter value will be 1. So it will, counter is less than, because counter is 1 and it is less than 3840. And in second attempt or second iteration, now after in the end of the first iteration, we will increase the value of the counter. So in second iteration, it will check this condition again. Now the counter is 1001, and which is again less than 3840. And in third iteration, it will become 2001. And so on, 3001 and less than 3840. And in fourth iteration, it will become 4001 to 3840. In the fourth, this iteration, this condition will become false. But see, in first iteration, we will read first 1000 record. In second iteration, we will read next 1000 records. So till here, we will read 2000 records. And in this, we will read 3000 records. And in this condition, we will read the remaining 840 records instead of 1000, because at the end, 840 records will left. So let me show you how we will read these records. So this is the while condition which we just saw. And we are using this this SQL query or SQL statement to read the data. This SQL query is, let me show you. Let's see. In this query, we are doing select star from sheet 1. And here we have given the range. Usually we use this query select star from sheet 1, but in this condition or in this SQL statement, we have given a range of the Excel, means if you want to read from A1 to let me show you. See, in our Excel file, if you want to read from this A1 to D5, means if you want to read first 5 rows, 4 rows, So we can give this range A1 and the last column, last cell E5. But in our example, we are going to read 1000 rows. So we will give 1000. So this is the first approach which we can follow. But what we are doing is we are giving, instead of A1, we are giving the value of the counter, because counter contains, in first iteration, it will contain 1, in second it will contain 1001, like that. So if we talk about first iteration, so it contains A counter, means A1, to E, we are giving count, means it will read the from A1 to 3840. A1 to E3840. But the scene here is we can't read the 3840's record in one attempt. We can only read 1000 record. So we are going to apply a condition or a limit. Maximum number of records to fetch is 1000. So in first iteration, it will read the first 1000 records. So in next iteration, it will become a counter, means counter will become 1001 and this E will remain same. In next iteration, it will read from A1001 to 2000. And in next iteration, it will read A2001 to T3840. And in next iteration, it will read 3001 to 3840. And in the last iteration, or in the last step, we will get only 840 records. But in first three iteration, we will get 1000 records, because we have set maximum number of records to fetch is 1000. So this is how we can read a fixed number of records from our Excel. And if your Excel is creating issue or doing something, so we can, so you can divide the data in the batches and you can read the data. And also, after reading this data, we can use a write condition, means we get first 1000 records here, and then we can traverse over those records. So in this loop condition, we can use a insert statement.
Let's get that on English channel.
Insert. And for this, we have to create a new connection, because we are going to insert the data in a different workbook. So for that, we need to connect to different workbook. And then we can disconnect to that workbook. So now in this loop state, we have all the thousand records. So we can apply a SQL statement of insert into the name of that table or the sheet, and then we can insert the data to the new workbook or the new worksheet. We have this data in this Excel row, so we can use that. Excel row 0 will contain the name of the employee, Excel row 1 will contain role, like that. So guys, this is how we can read millions of rows from Excel file or from any other file also, like CSV, TXT, TXT, etc. We can use OLEDB for those as well. And we can, after reading the data in the batches or in the small amount, we can process that data, and then we can read the next batch, or we can get the next 1000 or 500 records, whatever we want. So this is how it will become easy process. So thank you guys for watching this video. Do let me know if you still have any doubt or any question in this.